actual loose leaf.
The New York Jets, right?
Yeah, right. Yeah, right. Division three. I was at the University of Minnesota. I was in the Big Ten. I was a scholarship athlete, and I got in an argument with the defense coordinator, spiraled down, wound up at Rome University. It was the first thing they were even called Rome University. Before that, it was Westboro State. I get picked up by the Jets as a free agent, and the whole thing with the rookies is we stand in the back of the room in one of the first weeks of practice, and you have to stand up and give your fight song.
Oh, nice.
I had no idea what the fight song was. Pete Carroll's our coach, and I stand up. And my Stink is my sack persona, and my nickname, Bill, is the name that I played under football. So I stand up, and Bill Fisher, defensive line, Rome University. Every single head in the room goes like this. Coach, we have no fight song. And they just laughed their asses off, and I sat back down, and then I think they caught me like the next day.
So you escaped a lot of the cranial damage that if you'd had a long career. So you're built to be the heavy. Have you ever played any in like a meek, small, mild mannered, or are you always?
I don't fucking meet you.
I just want to know how good of an actor you are.
That is out for discussion. My father, Herb Fisher, may he rest in peace. He was a playwright and author. Had books that are out, and I had some scripts that were optioned back in the day. He passed away in 2001. But up until that point, when I was playing football and I was making the transition into acting, my dad would always say to me, "I'll make a good heaven." And I would get so pissed off. I'm like, I'm more than that, man.
That's
I'm
right.
with that.
That's right.
And Dan, you know what I'm talking about. He's come from the same background. But just amazing that I get these opportunities. And there is more to me. And I actually have a film coming out, Just One More Kiss, that is literally just wrapping up post right now, where I'm actually the love interest. And I actually, we're the most softer, sweet side.
I beat the shit out of you!
I feel it in such a sweet and caring way. Oh, it just comes down to love.
You are multifaceted. You're an author as well.
I'm a screenwriter.
Script
that's optioned right now and it's being worked through and we're moving into the next
one. Is this Bro Mitzvah?
How do you know Bro Mitzvah?
It's the best title of a movie ever.
Coach, it's going to take a roll by storm, so just stay tuned for Bro Mitzvah.
Bro Mitzvah, stay tuned.
And can I just say one thing? First of all, this is Brandon Debbie breaking through membranes. And this business is so difficult. And I think everybody in this audience and everyone else standing up here can attest to that. This is such a difficult industry to break through barriers. They're put up for us all the time in various ways, to our laterals, to our fronts, to our backs, above us and below us. It's so hard to break through, and to put Vivica in a spot to break through yet another ceiling and push it forward. Budgets mean shit. They really do, because at the end of the day, it's what's behind it that counts.
That's right.
And can you please make your way to Washington, D.C. like right now?
I'm on my way. Are you kidding? Yeah.
Thank you all very much for coming out and supporting
us. Yes,
you
are awesome.
Between you guys, you soldiers, how much of that was improv on set? How much did you actually come up with, and how much was actually written?
First of all, I'm going to say a good portion of it was improv, but before I went back, I was in law enforcement.
Oh.
I've been in law enforcement for over 27 years.
Right.
And people that you endure. So it basically, it helped me out in that aspect also.
Wow.
Yes.
So what was it that took you, so you were a police officer?
Yes.
What was it that made you go, you know what, I'm tired of making a lot of money, let's be an actor.
Well, you know what, basically I have a son. My son had expressed interest in acting, and so he was interested in taking classes, and so I would always take him to his classes and go and do things with him.
Yeah.
And you know, he had an opportunity to work with some wonderful people like John Abrams and a few other people like Andy Potts and stuff. And I was always on set, we would always rehearse. And it was something I had a passion for, but you know, my son pushed that in me and he inspired it, so that's what helped me do it.
Beautiful. Wow.